Здравствуйте! This episode is part of an ongoing series, so click on the card on the top right corner in order to watch your previous ones. In this video, we'll be setting up a mapper I've made myself. First, head on my GitHub repository and download the GNI mapper. Then download this C++ JSON library. Now back into the project, the first thing we're going to do is inside of the main.cpp file, we're going to remove the old exploits we had. Then right click on robot.h and click remove and finally delete. Now right click on cminecraft.h and remove and delete it as well. Also, don't forget to remove the classes filter. Then inside of gni.h, remove their includes and also remove everything that is under the init game classes block. We're also going to get rid of their smart pointers inside of the public block. Now right click on the project solution and click open folder in file explorer. Now head inside of the dependencies include folder and open the downloaded JSON library zip file inside of another file explorer. And head inside of the single include folder and just drag and drop JSON.hpp inside of the dependencies include folder. Now create a new folder inside of that include folder called JNI mapper and do the same process as you just done for the JSON lib, but do it with the downloaded JNI mapper. Now inside of the project, right click on the dependencies filter and click add new filter. Call this filter JNI mapper and then right click on this new filter and then click add existing item and select all the files of the JNI mapper that you just added inside of the include directory. Now right click on the dependencies folder and again click on add existing item and then just add the json.hpp file. Now inside JNI.h just include the JNI mapper and now create an instance of this JNI mapper which we will change to a smart pointer later on. Now in the source of the project, create a new filter called utils and add a file called rsc.h. Now we're gonna need a hex editor and I recommend you use ImHex, which you can download from this page by just clicking and scrolling to the ImHex download for Windows. Once it is installed, head into the zip file of mappings and under mappings, extract the file the JSON and then drag and drop this extracted file inside of ImHex. Now using your mouse, just select all the bytes, then right click on it and click on copy as and C array. Now paste the contents that are copied inside of your clipboard inside of rsc.h. Then include the CSTD and library and also add the inline keyword to the pasted content. After that, include rc inside of gni.h and change that instance of mapper to a smart pointer using unique pointer. Now inside of the constructor of jni, inside of the init game classes block, add a initializer for the mapper smart pointer and pass mappings and p and v as arguments. Now if we take a peek inside of that jni.json file we extracted earlier, as you can see, it's just a bunch of classes and fields for it with methods. I plan on adding more and maybe for other versions of Minecraft in the future, and what's really useful about that is that it's very, very customizable for every version of Minecraft. It will make everything much easier than having to create the classes ourselves inside of the C++ project. Now inside of the main.cpp file, we're going to initialize the instance of the Minecraft class by just accessing its static the Minecraft member it has. And then using the mapper, we're just going to remake that right click zero delay exploit we had before. And finally re-add that auto clicker, but this time just by calling a function that is inside of the Minecraft class, which is called clickMouse. Now in order to add a delay for it, we're going to use this thread sleep4 and just pass in milliseconds a 50. You can play with these values and add the modulo we had before to make it variate and make it more slow. Now if you inject inside of Minecraft, you should get this print inside of the console, which will just tell you that it was able to get the Minecraft class and its fields and methods. And as you can see, I am totally fast bridging and auto clicking and it's pretty abused. And we're finally reaching the end of this episode and series, but don't worry, it is not exactly the end for me. I will still be uploading content related to this stuff, but I will focus on making exploits like reach hack and aimbot and other things like this. And yes, we will be still using the same source code I made all along this series. So thanks for watching along and I'll see you in the next one.